Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Bring this energy to the heart. Gazing inwardly at your third eye. Inhale deeply. Exhale all the way out, sit a little taller. Inhale. Exhale. And let the mantra resonate in the skull. Exhale, let it go. Hands rest on the knees. Coming into Sufi grind. We'll do a minute and a half in each direction. You can close your eyes, and I'd like you to start by going counterclockwise. So your belly will come forward and then go to the left. And back and around. Reverse the direction. Thank you. Inhale to center. Exhale. Bring your hands to your shins. Inhale, flex the heart forward. Exhale, flex it back. And keep it going. Inhale to center. Exhale, notice your space. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, bend the elbows out to the sides. Fingers come in front of the shoulders, thumbs behind. Elbows stay lifted. Last warm up. Inhale as you twist to the left. Exhale as you twist to the right and let your head fall. Inhale to center.
Sadanga Sangi Abangam Vibhuti.
And come lying onto your back for our Kriya. Relaxing on the back with the legs out long. And then just hug the knees into the chest for a moment. And keep your right knee hugged in and let your left leg relax out long. And take this right knee across the body into a twist, reaching the right arm away. We're coming into the magnificent nine Kriya for youthfulness. You can let your head relax away from the knee. And let's come into long, deep breathing. As you inhale, fill your belly first, then the rib cage, then the chest. And as you exhale, release your breath from top to bottom. You can make your breath smooth and slow. And draw that right knee into center. Switch legs, hugging the left knee in. Bring it across the body into a twist. Keep your long, deep breathing. And layer on the mantra, Sat Nam. As you inhale, mentally vibrating Sat, which means truth. As you exhale, mentally vibrating Nam, I am. Draw that knee back in. Let it go. Inhale, reach the arms up over the head, getting long. Exhale, bend the elbows, bring your hands over the heart and rub the hands together vigorously.
Now bring the hands over the eyes and open your eyes into the hands. Very slowly, let a little bit of light in at a time as you draw the pinky edges of the hands together. And allow the hands to rise up above the face. Eventually, let them release. And take your fingertips to your forehead, gently massaging the forehead and then the temples. Massaging the cheeks. The nose. Upper lip. And chin. And then just go right down the neck. Reach your arms down so that the hands are hovering over the thighs. Tuck your chin, gazing at your toes, pointing them. If possible, lift the feet up off the floor or just lift one at a time and we'll alternate them. Breath of fire. Your feet are lifting about 1 foot above the earth. Inhale deeply. Gather all of that energy from the pose. Hold the breath. Exhale, relax. Let the energy distribute through the body. And come back to your long, deep breathing. And keep this breath as you flip over onto the belly. Place your hands down on the earth on either side of your ribcage. And as you gently press into the hands, glide the shoulders down the back, squeezing the elbows in towards your sides, lifting up for cobra. If this feels like too much, you can always have the forearms down. Good. Keep those shoulders gliding down the back. Keep your smooth breath. Inhale, come into your best cobra possible. Lifting the energy upwards. Exhale, bend your knees. Sinking back. Gliding your body into tabletop. Knees underneath the hips, hands underneath the shoulders. And then draw the heels of your feet together behind you. Let your eyelids close, gazing at your third eye center. Inhale into sway back to cow. Exhale, start by tucking the tailbone as you round into Halloween cat. Just finding your own pace, inhaling sat, exhaling nam. If it's comfortable, speed it up for these last few seconds. Inhale and just sway back, cow. Can you lengthen your spine even more? Mool Bandha is lifting. Good. Exhale, come right down onto your sitting bones. Let your legs release out long. Walk your hands down to the shins. Holding on to the shins, let's start here. Inhale as you lengthen up. You can even gaze up at the top. Exhale as your belly folds first, then your heart, then your head. Use your inhale to roll up. Your head is always following last. Exhale as you roll down. This should feel like a wave. You're cleansing your body with breath and movement. You're opening up that life force nerve that runs up the backs of the legs. You're welcome to keep the hands on the shins, or you might be able to bring them down to the ankles. And you're always welcome to try the big toes. Inhale into the lengthening up position. Exhale, folding all the way down. Hold the breath out for a moment. Inhale to release. Meditation. You're welcome to sit in easy pose for this, maybe sitting on a cushion. Or if it's comfortable to sit in rock pose, then you can sit on the shins. So just pick one that feels most comfortable for you. Let the hands rest on the legs, shoulders relaxing back and down, heart ever so slightly lifting, and then lengthen the back of the neck, allowing your chin to tuck slightly. Relax the tongue and let the dome of the mouth rise. Maybe having some awareness at the center of the forehead. This home of inner wisdom. Let your ears open to listening. Noticing this moment. And as you listen, listen for that subtle sat-nam on your breath. Inhale deeply. Lifting will bend, inviting energy up the spine. Exhale, let it wash back down. We'll come into restorative fish pose. So gather a blanket and maybe a pillow as well. And you're going to fold your blanket in a way that you can lay your spine on top. So if I fold it in half, and then in half again, Then I'm going to fold it in thirds or even fourths so that I end up
with a blanket that looks about like this. Doesn't have to be exactly like this, but similar to this.
And then I'm going to lay this blanket where my spine is going to end up. So my sacrum is going to come right to the edge of the blanket. And you have a pillow here for extra height if you end up wanting it. So just keep it here. I'll show you this in a second. You can lay your spine down on your blanket. If you need extra cushioning for your head, feel free to use your cushion for that. Or if you just want your heart to be higher, you can always place the pillow underneath the back of your heart, wherever is comfortable, just for a little bit of extra height. And then let your arms rest by the sides. This should feel comfortable. So take a moment to make any adjustments that you might need
in order to be comfy here. Good. My cat is at the window asking to come in. So we're gonna be here for 5 minutes. Just rest.
Thank you.
And gently deepen your breath here. You can roll to one side and just release your props out from underneath you.
And our last pose in this Kriya before Shavasana is shoulder stand. So you're welcome to modify by placing your pillow underneath the sacrum and letting the legs come up to the sky like this. If you'd like to come into full shoulder stand, then you can lift the hips up off the floor, inch your elbows in towards each other, walk your hands towards your upper back, and reach those toes up. Either way, keep your long, deep breath going. This pose is wonderful for your thyroid gland. Even if you're modifying, this is still going to work. Every pose in this Kriya is working towards youthfulness and beauty. Detoxifying any areas that might be holding on to emotional or physical toxicity. Helping your inner light, the beauty of your inner light, to shine through. And having a glow to the skin. We have about one more minute here. You're always welcome to come down early. Keep your breath. When you're ready, nice and slow, you can release. And we'll come into Shavasana pose, resting on the back, legs out long. Let the palms of your hands face up towards the sky. As we rest in this pose, we let go of any effort. Allow gravity to hold you, even embrace you, as you relax. Gently begin to deepen your breath. Wiggling fingers and toes. Making little circles at the wrists and the ankles in each direction. Stretch the arms up over the head. Hug the knees into the chest. Take a little cat stretch, a little twist to each side. And when you're ready, you can bring your knees back to center. Coming into a happy baby. Good. And we'll rub the soles of the feet together and the palms together. Let your feet release, let your hands rest anywhere on the body that could use some extra attention. And rock it up to seated. Bringing the palms together at the heart. Notice who you'd like to send the benefits of your practice to today. Anything, anyone that comes to you, see them. You can join in with the longtime sun if you like. Thank you.
The light in me honors the light in you. Remembering that we are all one beyond time, space, this body, this mind. Sign off.